Lord provided, and this is really exciting to see this many people at a baptism. And so let's just open it up and ask the Lord's blessing on it. Heavenly Father, again, we thank you for another day, a day that you made and your beautiful creation. And more than that, Lord, that you're here with us, and we have some testimonies today, and these folks are going to be baptized, and it's so exciting for me to see these two young people, and one middle-aged and one older person. It is absolutely exciting to you to see that your spirit is at work in our lives. And so I thank you for their testimony and their lives, and looking forward to a good time here and a good testimony to you in Christ's name.
Amen.
The only thing I wanted to say about the baptism this morning, as Pastor John also alluded to in his sermon, it's a beautiful symbolic act of what has happened when you've been transformed through Christ. But also, it's a great act of obedience. And I will admit to you, I kind of had that out of context as a new believer. I didn't look at it like that, but it's an awesome act of obedience. Jesus himself was baptized. He didn't have to be. But he was, because everything he said and did was to the Father's will. So it's a great testimony to everyone around you when you are a believer and you are baptized. That's all I got.
Okay, first we're going to baptize the two Arboleta's men here, the young men, because Rex wants to get in this and he has to be to work. So do you two guys have anything you would like to share? We'll take the oldest first.
Maybe when I accepted Jesus as my Savior.
Louder, please.
Maybe when I accepted Jesus as my Savior. So it was Easter time, and we went to Christ the Rock to see Jesus being crucified. And we saw like examples of how big the nails were, the whips, and then there's like this video of Jesus being crucified. And I felt like, why did Jesus me, even though I'm a sinner? Then I realized, because he cares and he loves for us. And after the video was over, went to this like big cross, and I asked Dad, how can I accept Jesus as my Savior? So he told me to repeat what he says, and after I did that, he was like, I'm happy that you accepted Jesus as your Savior. So
amen.
Happened, so.
It's a fantastic testimony, and he went into detail with that with me, and so congratulations. That is the best decision you'll ever make. And keep walking with that.
Yeah.
So I wanted to get baptized for a while. Ever since I saw like my three older siblings get baptized, I've wanted to get baptized. But when I went to Catholic school, it was all this different stuff about it. And sometimes it would be like pointing out if you're not baptized, you wouldn't go to heaven. So it kind of had an impact on me. But when my mom showed me this video about Christ and such, I wanted to get baptized, and that's when I accepted Jesus that day. So I'm glad that I'm able to be baptized today with the rest of you guys.
Amen.
Thank you.
But God, who called
me, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. All because of your testimony, faith in Jesus Christ, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Got some
Yes.
One first.
I'll just stay right here. Go, I'll just get used to it.
Okay.
Kneel on both knees.
My chains are gone. I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy.
Forever.